we're bringing you guys to the grocery store with us. We haven't done that in, I feel like it's been a really long time. While we're getting out of the car, I just wanted to talk to you guys for a minute and let you know what we've been up to. The past week or so, Farabee and I have been trying to go to business events so that we can get business for our new business. Up until then, Farabee's not ever gone to anything like that, you know, that she had to basically be professional through. So I wasn't sure like how that was gonna go, and it's going so well. So the first one, she was a little bit unsure what to do. Second one, honestly, she was a little unsure what to do there too, but it wasn't the same. Like, I don't know, the second one, she got comfortable a lot quicker, and I got comfortable a lot quicker too. I feel like I was very uncomfortable at the first one, but we're gonna go to the store, we're gonna bring you guys with us, and we'll see you in a minute. Unfortunately, they didn't have my body scrub, which is honestly like probably 80% of the reason I went out today, because I don't have enough to have a shower tomorrow and I just don't like to not have body scrub. So I don't know, we might go somewhere else later, but I just got what I needed. I didn't want to leave, you know, I feel like that's kind of a jerk. Like, I had stuff in my cart, I didn't want to like push the cart aside and leave and go to a different store. So we might go somewhere else, but we're gonna go home now. So we will see you guys in a minute. Grocery haul, black cherry Waterloo, pretzels, two things of jasmine rice, a big thing of PB Fit for my smoothies, super greens, veggie burgers, two kombuchas. So I got a mango passion fruit and a pomegranate lemonade, raspberry vinegar dressing, chicken nuggets, of tomatoes, broccoli, cauliflower, and carrots. I got some bananas, frozen pineapple, this organic, this pre-cut. Then I got frozen cherries. They're not organic. That's what I got. We didn't get a lot. So I wanted to give you guys an update on what we've been up to. So this week, Farabee and I started trying to go out and do some business networking. Obviously, in my life, I've worked out, you know, in public and and done that type of stuff where you talk to people, but not since my incident. I haven't, and I wasn't sure. Number one, I wasn't sure how I was gonna do, first off, because, you know, it's intimidating. And then I wasn't sure how Farabee was gonna do, just because, you know, she's not done stuff like that. But she has done amazing, and I'm really proud of her. I'm honestly really proud of myself too. For somebody who has all the problems that I have, it's like a huge, huge deal to have faith in yourself that, you know, you can actually do that. And obviously Farabee is an amazing helper, and I trust her. At this point, I really trust her a ton that she will be able to help me, and I trust that she'll behave herself, and, you know, I won't have to babysit her and like do training while we're somewhere. It went really well. We went to actually two events this week, which honestly for me mentally that was a little bit much, and for Farabee it was a lot too. The thing we did yesterday, we were gone for quite a while. It was several hours that we were gone. I liked that a lot. It was super fun. But I know Farabee was tired whenever we got home, and I was exhausted. We went to bed before 10 o'clock. Farabee, whenever we got home, she only said two words on her buttons yesterday. She usually, I think her average is like 42. So that tells you she was really, really tired. And we were gone a long time. And we were gone kind of during the prime time of when she would normally have things to say. So, you know, it kind of makes sense. I enjoyed it, and I'm really proud of us. Basically, the point of me telling you this is, if you're a person who's feeling like, you know, you want to go out and do stuff like that, and that maybe you're going to be looked at as weird for having your dog with you, nobody was put off by her. There was one person who was a little bit too excited to see a dog, and they were like trying to interact with her a little bit, but it wasn't a big deal. And at this point, Farabee is trained enough for me to say, okay, you know, come on back now, because they'd actually called her. And, you know, if it wasn't the way it was, like, I was sitting in a chair, so it wasn't a big deal. Like, really, it's a big deal because of principle, and it's a big deal because I don't want her to think that's okay. But at the same time, it's not a big deal because I knew I was safe. I was in, you know, inside of a building, sitting down. I was gonna be there for quite a while, so if something happened, you know, I wasn't planning on leaving like right then anyway, so it wasn't a big deal in the sense of, you know, if I started to have something go on, I felt safe, let's put it that way. If she missed something, I didn't feel like it was gonna put my life at stake or anything. So, that. But everyone we met was super, super nice. Both of the places, the people who, you know, actually, I guess, owned the places, or either were managers at the places, one or the other, were really nice. I did make a point to get there a little bit early for the second one because it was a different type of a business, because they serve drinks and stuff there, and I wanted to make sure that they knew, you know, that Farabee was with me and that she was a service dog, and make sure that I answered any questions, you know, ahead of time, rather than setting us up to just kind of walk in with everybody and potentially get called out, because you know how that goes. Sometimes you don't think anyone's gonna say anything, and then you have a person who's gonna, you know, think they're gonna be the hero of the establishment and call you out. But like I said, I just got there a few minutes early and made sure, you know, I spoke to the first person I saw and just made sure they knew I had a dog with me, made sure they knew she was a service dog, and they're like, no worries, it's totally cool. So, which, you know, obviously I knew it was totally cool, but just to kind of, I don't know, I always feel more comfortable to cross that bridge before we get to it, and before I put us in an awkward position to where I'm called out in front of a group of like 30 people who I don't know for having a dog somewhere, and then I have to stand up and, you know, basically do ADA battle with somebody. So anyways, all of that to say, it went really well. And basically the point of me popping this into a video is because I want to tell you guys, I keep looking at Farabee, her hair is like tickling my leg. So I just want to tell you guys, if you're a person who's in a situation like that where you feel like you need to go to stuff, you know, to try to get business, and you feel self-conscious about having your dog with you, or I guess anything really, but if anything, I feel like it was an icebreaker, and it helped me to kind of talk to people who, you know, maybe I would have not normally been able to talk to, because people kind of are curious about the dog. And so I think it actually benefited me, to be honest. Like, I really think it actually benefited me. And, you know, obviously you're gonna have people. I didn't have anyone who acted like she was unwelcome by any means, but I'm sure, anytime you meet a group of people, I'm sure there's going to be a few people in the group who are probably thinking that, you know, why do you have your dog with you? And they might form their own unpleasant opinion about you. Let's put it that way. But I didn't experience anyone treating me that way outwardly, which was awesome. And I feel like therapy is a good icebreaker because, you know, people, at least even if they might not have a reason to talk to you about your business, at least they usually will say hello and say something about the dog, which typically you guys know that's normally not a great thing, but in this situation it really worked out well for us. So anyways, I just wanted to encourage you guys and let you know, you can do it. I can, if I did it, you guys can do it. I felt like I had to be really, really brave to go do that. And I'm really proud of myself. And like I said, I'm so proud of Fairby. Fairby did amazing, but you know, Fairby's kind of in a position where she doesn't have a choice. She just has to go and do whatever with me. I knew she would do good, or I had a feeling she would do good, and she did really good. And I'm really proud of myself though. So, and I never say that. I never get on here and I'm like, I'm so proud of myself, because I feel like it's kind of like, I don't know, it's just awkward to say that. Like I've said with you guys before, I always want to share with you guys and be as honest as I can about things. And if that means that I'm proud of myself or something, and I want to encourage you to do something that might be scary, safe things that are scary, then, you know, do it and be proud of yourself, because it's awesome. It feels awesome. So anyways, I feel really proud of myself. Fairby is proud of us. Fairby's hot. We're going to go in. So anyways, I hope you guys have an awesome week, and we will see you soon. Bye guys.